Good evening, guys, on YouTube. Shakira Lover Forever here. This is going to be my last video of the Westinghouse washing machine because I've had my fun with it. It's going to go into the garage where I'll use it occasionally, and I will be putting another machine in to try to film to show you guys. It's like the washers just keep going in and out. Right, so love this machine to bits, but it's time for a change, so let's just do one last load on it. So I'm going to do this really huge load of blankets. That would probably, like, essentially kill a front loader. So we're going to see how it handles in this big 9.5kg washing machine. I'm going to use some Dynamo Professional Disc 7-in-1 actions. They keep changing the formula. This is like the previous one, but that's fine. We'll chuck two of them in there because it's a big load. I'm also going to put a little wee dot of varnish in there. Just to... Because these blankets are actually really dirty. Let's just say I've got a dog and a cat, and the dog's having her time in the month. Time every 6 months or whatever it is they have. And I'm going to use... because it's like bedding blankets and stuff, I'm going to use Cuddly Vanilla, which is a really nice... gentle vanilla scent, and it just smells really nice, so that's what I'm going to use. But as you know, I'm going to add it in on the second deep rinse, so I'm going to let it complete its cycle before I do another rinse on its own. These are pretty big blankets, so I'm going to use the super high water level and see how it goes. I probably shouldn't really put too much in here, but I'm sure it can handle it. And I've got like a woolen jumper, which goes nicely with a delicate fluffy theme, and a dog blanket. So that's a fairly big load. Alright. Maxi wash, we're going to do heavy soil because it's really heavily soiled. We'll do extra high level, we'll have like warm hot, I don't want it too hot. High spin, deep rinse, 62 minutes. Don't need any soaking or anything, the extra action is fine. Yeah, and then I'll do another rinse and spin after. Okay, off we go. It's a pretty huge load, so I'm hoping it's going to water down a little bit and then everything's going to move nicely. Westinghouse is a really popular brand in Australia. They mainly focus on kitchen brands, but loads of people have the fridges, the washers. They've just brought out a new range of Westinghouse washers and dryers. They haven't had them out in years. Probably this was probably the last one they had, which was from about 2006. So I wouldn't mind getting one of the new top loaders to try. They look really nice. They've got like a black panel and a dark lid, but still see-through if you use a torch. The 12 kilo model has the wash plate with the recirc jet, so that could be kind of nice. So once it's filled up, I'll give the glass a wipe and then you'll be able to see it clearer once it starts agitating. So that's hot only fill. So because it's warm hot, it will cycle on the cold water. So we'll get a bit of a cold and a hot fill. That's it, just engaging the tub lock so it doesn't move while it's agitating. Pardon me. Do you need to really? I'm trying to record cat Snickers. Hey. Oh god, here we go. Right. What are you wanting? She just likes to make mess and chew stuff like all over the place. Oh, she does my nut in, man. I might actually add some sanitizing rinse as well. Because maybe some of this stuff. Because yeah, I just need them like really goodly, nicely sanitized. Big yawn. Right, I'll come back when it's filled because it's going to take like a while. Right, we're almost there and I've just wiped the lid. Didn't take too long actually, which is awesome. So we're about to start agitating. 62 minutes left. Time starts now. Let's see if we get some good agitation with this big load today. Yeah, that looks like it's moving absolutely fine. So that's the highest level you can have, which is really high. I'm just going to fix that green thing because it's annoying me. Okay, that's better. So that's really hot water in there, and quite a decent agitation, so quite a long agitation. It's going to be washing for about just under half an hour, about 24 minutes or something. So that's going to give it time to really move it all around. Give them a good wash. Really? Off. Move. Honestly. See, it's slowly but surely pulling it all under. See, it's pulling it all to the middle. So, I was going to say, I wonder if it's a bit overloaded, but nah, that's fine because it's actually moving them. As long as everything ends up getting pulled to the middle and coming back up to the sides, that's what you want, so that everything gets a go at the bottom agitator. Thank you. really. We just can't leave you alone, these animals, man. That blue blanket is slowly but surely getting pulled down into the middle. It's a slow action, but it gets it in the end. See, because it's such a long wash, it ends up getting everything moved around. No worries about it. There you go, it's nearly gone. Basically a gentle giant, but it does the job. Right, I'll let it wash some more and then I'll come back and record the rest of the wash. ...38 minutes left, still washing away. Sorry, you're going to just have to excuse the cat who's decided to make his bed on top of there. Probably because it's quite warm and he likes the vibrations, probably. Makes him sleepy. And also probably knows that he's in my way. You're just going to have to watch this from here. Now this is going to be a crazy spin, I think. It's going to be trying to drain out all that water really quick. You'll hear the water flushing out the drain as soon as it starts spinning. ...33 minutes left. think we're struggling to drain there. Yep, there we go. Sad to log. You can do this thing where you actually advance this, like this is the pulse part, you can advance it and it goes straight to the main spin. So we've got 14 minutes left, I'm going to try it. Yeah, look at that, straight to 7 minutes, straight to the full spin. Yeah, that's all you can do. You can just, it's so weird, you can just literally advance it and skip that little bust part. I'm not sure if you can advance it in the rest of the cycle, like if you can advance the wash to drain or not. I'm assuming you can. Just saves a bit of time, you know? I'll let it do it, once I do my final softener rinse, I'll let it do the full thing. But I just wanted to spin them out quickly just to get the softener in. Yeah, because it does the pulses and then reaches speed. Then it slows down and then it does another full bust. Then back down and then back up to full speed for like 6 minutes. But yeah, by advancing it, you just go straight from the pulses to the final spin. Right, I'll come back once that's stopped. There you go. Lovely. Yeah, they smell lovely and fresh. Dynamo always smells good. Now, one cup of cuddly vanilla. Oh, I love that smell. And we'll do one cup of the Activo sanitizer. That looks a bit weird, doesn't it? Alright, straight to rinse. Oh, advance. Extra high level. Deep rinse only and spin 24 minutes. I love that little spinny lock tub thing. Ugh, lid's getting a bit dirty now. It's not dirt, it's just old age scratches and everything. And the light's showing it up. There we go. Right into the middle of the water. Oh, that smells amazing. I'm getting whiffs of vanilla and like really clean, fresh scent. I'll just show you something really cool, right? So sometimes if I'm washing bulky items in top loaders, sometimes I feel like it might not mix them quite as much as it should. So look at this. I've got a massive wooden spoon and I just go like that. Give it a good push, everything down just to help it mix a little bit. Just on the odd occasion, if I'm washing like duvets, blankets, it just helps to get that softener and detergent, whatever, like, you know, flushed right through it. So you're just helping it out a wee bit. So it just makes sure everything gets right under, flushed through the water. Normally I hate interfering with machines, and I know they like they do their own thing and whatever, and I hate people mucking about with washers, but this is one thing I don't mind doing every now and again, just to give it a wee helping hand. My big massive spoon. I think you're supposed to use it for cooking, not for pushing down washers. But there you go. That's just helped it along. It looks like it's moving faster now, actually. Behind it, you're also washing pillows and stuff, which tend to float. You could use that spoon and just get them all flushed down every now and again, every few minutes. Water looks nice and clear. Double rinse really helps with most bigger loads, especially in this machine since there's no spray rinse in the middle. Hope you've enjoyed this series of Westinghouse washer videos. Stay tuned to see what's next.